Operation Leader was the first combat experience that I'd had, and we were operating with the British Home Fleet. We made some strikes on German shipping along the Norwegian coast. Well, I'd been seasick the night before, and when we went up to the ready room, the skipper knew that I'd been seasick, and so he said, we'll send Sousa on the flight. But then he decided that I should go, so we took off before dawn. Our orders were to stay down below 50 feet to avoid radar pickup. And we were a complete surprise. We launched about 100 miles out, made landfall, and started attacking ships. We attacked in two plane sections. We were each equipped with 400 or 500 pound bombs, 10-second delay fuses. And the fighters were to go in first and strafe, and then we were to follow in a glide bombing or a masthead bombing attack. So I attacked this German ship, and the first run I made on it, I dropped two bombs and splashed water on the ship. So I did a wing over and came back in on the water level and right toward the ship, dropped my last two bombs. About the time I dropped the bombs, I got hit with an anti-aircraft. A 20 millimeter shell hit the engine. I flamed up temporarily, but the flame went out and I just started smoking. I climbed up to about 1,000, 1,500 feet, told the crew to bail out. Unfortunately, my belly gunner popped his chute in the plane and couldn't get out. The turret gunner called me just in time before I jumped. So I told the crew to settle down. We'd land in the water. But I started to make a water landing toward this island, and turned out it had some anti-aircraft batteries on it, and I started seeing these tracers, so I pulled up, thought, well, I don't know how this plane will fly all the way to the carrier. It was only 90 miles to Sweden. Sweden was neutral. I looked at the mountains, snow on the mountains. I thought, there's no place to land if my engine conks out before I get to Sweden. So I turned back toward the carrier. And that darn plane flew 100 miles all the way to the carrier. Smoking all the way. My windscreen was completely covered with oil. So I was the first one to make the carrier. The carrier wasn't turned into the wind. And I made one pass at it crossways. The engine was still running. I made a fast turn and lined up the flight deck. I didn't realize that the signal officer was giving me a wave off. I knew I couldn't go around again, so I cut the gun, hit the barrier, and hit the island at the same time with my wing. But I got aboard, and they started squirting water and fire retardant on the plane. Ran forward, ran into the deck officer, and he grabbed me. He said, "You so-and-so," he said, "you've fouled up this flight deck and we can't get those other planes aboard." Well, I went on down to the ready room and figured I would do for a court-martial or something. But they cleaned the flight deck off. They cleared the wreckage out in just a short time, took it down below on the hangar deck, and eventually I got an air medal instead of a court-martial. So that was my first exposure to combat when I was in the Navy.